Hi everyone, I'm Ariel Yoga Girl. I'm here to give you some free sequences this summer. I want to be posting on YouTube just free videos, free flows for you in aerial yoga, regular yoga, vinyasa flow on the mat, as well as some meditations including kundalini, which I absolutely am loving right now. So I'm going to be taking you through that totally free. Now I know I have KamaFit TV and you can totally visit that as well. And that's a subscription series with voiceover, slowed down instruction. So this is gonna go a little bit faster than KamaFit TV, but I wanna take you through some of my favorite sequences and flows and talk you through them. And if you like this, hopefully you'll subscribe to KamaFit TV or just subscribe to this YouTube channel and I'll be keep busting these out every week for you. We're gonna start with a down dog flow today. So we take our hammock, make sure you're warmed up first. We're gonna be placing the fabric right on our hip bones, right on our hip hinge. So when I forward fold over the fabric, my legs are gonna go wide and it's not in my stomach. I'm gonna be pressing the floor away with my hands firmly. The legs are going to rise up and hook around and in. So here, instead of keeping my head posted up, I will sink my ears down between my shoulders and maybe even let my hips sway side to side. Locking the toes in is an option. You can also unlock for flying dog, flex and point the toes and let it feel good. I'm gonna rehook my feet here and we're gonna go into a three-legged dog. So staying on the hands, let's take the right foot to the floor first. So the right foot finds the ground. The left leg that's bent is going to crochet up the fabric by lengthening through my knee. So in this way, I get a nice stretch. I can even wag the tail, I call this, by just moving my hips but staying grounded in your standing leg. Now, if I want to turn over into my down dog flow sequence, a couple things we can do. I can press into my left hand, let my right arm reach up and grab the fabric above my hip, and there's a nice shoulder stretch here, all right? And if I put my right hand down, so my right leg is on the floor, right hand is on the floor, left leg is in the air, left arm reaches up. As you do this, it's a thumb up grip as high as you can grab, I'll turn so you can see. So it's a thumb up grip, palm facing out. And from this position, you can even elevate this foot off the ground and reach your arm forward. You may spin if you're on a single point like I am. If you're on a double point, you won't. And then you can totally rotate yourself, hips face the ceiling now. And in this way, my bottom leg, my right leg, which isn't doing much right now, I can reach for it, pushing the foot into my hand and get a nice stretch here. Arch the head back for a shoulder stretch as well. You can keep going. You can get out at any time by just reversing your steps and going back down to the mat, finding the floor with your right hand and then your left. If you want to continue, left hand's high, rotate your hips up to the ceiling. So this is work. You can bend this leg down or keep it extended and flexed so it's hooked on the silk. Right leg can come up or you can cross your right leg over your left. And this becomes more aerial dance and performance based than an aerial yoga stretch. But I'm working, my core is working, my upper body is working here. To come out, I have a few options. You can always reverse your steps, but if you wanna be fancy, my right leg is going to press nice and high, I'm leaning my head back, and I'm going to take the left leg out and under, and now I am in a position where I can straddle back, go to a gazelle or pigeon stretch, whatever you call this, gazelle, hold the poles, and slowly lift up. I like to end any inversion like that by supporting myself on the rib cage, pressing the feet firmly to the floor, and then getting myself a little bit of a back stretch, a baby back bend here, maybe even swaying right and left. And then obviously we would do the other side. So you would go back into your down dog. And this time, we drop the other foot, crochet this leg up. You can find your shoulder stretch. Either way, and then you turn yourself. So we'll do the right leg up, left hand down, right hand reaches. As I do this, this is a nice stretch on the side here. You can try to find a balance point here first, which is tricky. I'm really pressing my foot into the ground. If the hands find the fabric above my head, I need to be rotating my hips up to the ceiling. This leg can stay locked or bent. My free foot I can reach for, or I can cross it over. And I can always reverse my steps. So if I'm gonna reverse, I release that free leg, which would be the left leg. I find the floor with my hands first, and then I find it with my feet.
forward fold, breathe, pressing feet into floor, re-grounding myself, before finally with a flat back to protect the spine, rise tall, press the fabric in front of you, shoulder stretch here. So two different ways to get out of this sequence. If you're an aerial yoga teacher or aerial silk instructor, you can use this in class. If you're a student, please have your instructor break this down for you and work on it with them with a live instructor watching you, and always practice safely. You can keep coming back to this YouTube channel. Please subscribe. I'm gonna keep posting videos like this this summer. And I'm also gonna be doing yoga vinyasa on the mat and meditation guidance. So if you're into that, I hope you are, you can try it out. Please subscribe, hit subscribe. Instagram, I hope you are, you can try it out. Please subscribe, hit subscribe. Instagram, Aerial Yoga Girl, and KamaFit TV, KamaFitTV.com is where you'll find over 300 videos and aerial yoga sequences that are like 30 minutes long. You'll find aerial silk moves, tutorials, aerial sling moves, and conditioning drills to get you stronger to do a lot of your harder moves on the aerial fitness apparatus. So thank you so much for joining me. Please subscribe, and I'll see you guys later.